Good morning, students. Today, under visual programming, it is unit number 2. We just learned the chapter number 1, the name of 2010 environment. Let us see the learning objectives. The first one is, what is VB? What is meant by VB? Steps to open VB and exploring the VB screen. What are the parts that are available in VB screen? Steps to open a new project, label control and its properties, and steps to run the VB program. These are the points we just learned in this session. Let us see the first one. What is VB? VB, it stands for Visual Basic. VB means Visual Basic. It is a simple programming language. VB is nothing but a simple computer programming language. Here, programs are done in visual environment, so it is called as Visual Basic. What do you mean by the term visual? Visual means it is interacted with easier than we just see each and every step by means of our interaction. IDE environment, we use a term called IDE. In this VB, the programs are done in visual environment. It is an event-driven programming language. Now, we are going to learn a new word called event. Event. What do you mean by the term event? It means happening. Each and every happen. We just learn in VB. It is an event-driven programming language. That event can be happened with the help of three steps. When we click on a button or type a text into a text box or select an item from a list. These are the three types of events that can be take place in VB, each and every program. So it is called as an event-driven programming language. Programs have to be written for each event separately. It is an important point to know that for each and every event. I already told that there are three types of events that can be performed in VB. Either we click on a button or type a text into a text box or select an item from a list. Okay, these events can be performed by means of each and every event can be happened by means of write a coding for each and every. We must write a coding for each and every event separately. Next, steps to open VB. We are well known how to open an application. Go to start, all programs, Microsoft Visual Studio. In that we just select Microsoft Visual Studio 2010. After loading the VB screen, click on a new project option. I just explained with the help of screenshot now. Later I just demonstrate with the help of a VB application. Let us listen the PPT here. Click on new project option. In the new project dialog box, when you click a new project option, a new project dialog box will be open. In the dialog box, you just select Windows Form application option and then click the OK button. Let us learn the common terms that are used in the environment VB. Projects, forms and controls are the different words we are going to learn in this session. VB application is a collection of objects. Here, VB application means it is a collection of objects that can work together to do a certain task. So, it is a collection of objects that object can work to complete a certain task. That is called as a VB application. Let us see the loading of VB screen. This is a loading of VB screen. I just indicated with the help of a red color rectangle box. New project option is available here. No, you just click it. After click this option, what will happen? A new project dialog box will be opened here. In that, you just select the Windows Form application option. I note it here and click the OK button. This is a step to open VB application. Let us see the parts, exploring the VB environment. What are the different types of parts that are available in VB environment? It is easy when we compare to that of ZIMP environment. I already told you, we just learned in the previous unit, ZIMP now. Here, let us see the exploring. That is, what are the parts that are available in VB environment? The first one, form window. It is a place where we design our application. Form window means it is a place where we design our application. In ZIMP, the center white area, that is called as canvas. No, on the portion only we just draw or edit our images. Like that, in VB, the portion where we design the application is called as the form window. Go on to the next one, properties window. Each and every object, have particular separate property. Okay, that property can be changed to used to change the color, font, size, style, etc. For that purpose, you have to use the properties window. I just explain it later. Let us see the name of the portion, whatever available here. Move on to the next one. Solution Explorer window. The Solution Explorer window, it is otherwise called as Project Explorer window. The other name for Solution Explorer window is Project Explorer window. It allows to switch between design window and coding window. I explained it later with the help of screenshot, what is going to be design window and what is going to be coding window. First we just learn the parts name, what are the parts that are available in the VB environment. First one is a form window. It is a place where we design our application. Next one is a properties window. It is used to change the properties of each and every controls. And third one is a solution explorer window. It is otherwise called as project explorer window. It is used to toggle between the design window and coding window. Then final one is the toolbox. We are already learned toolbox. What is meant by toolbox? The different tools that is used for designing our application that are available in the toolbox and ZIMP. Similarly, here in the VB environment, the toolbox contains various tools that is used to design your application. Okay, this is a toolbox portion. Next, let us see the VB environment, how to remember the name of this window. The name can already be displayed in the each and every window. Here, form window, form one. Here, it is easy to remember that it is a form window. Next one, and the properties window at the top, at the title bar, you just see the properties, name called properties. Next in the solution explorer window, at the top, the title bar have solution explorer. So it is very easy to remember what window we just learn. Next one, this is a solution explorer window. I already told you, it is easy to switch between, it used to switch between coding window and designing window. No, so let us see the solution explorer window. Here it consists of so many buttons. The first one, view code, I just indicate with the help of a box, red color box. This button is called as view code button. Okay, view code button. What do you mean with the term view code? I already told you the Visual Basic is a event driven programming language. Event driven means any happenings that can be performed by means of an action. Okay, there are three types of action that can be performed. The first one is click on a button, or type a text into your text box, or select an item from a list. But I told you each and every event is to be happened by means of writing coding. You have to write the programs for each and every event separately. That codes can be written in this portion. View code portion only. You just type the codes for each and every event. When we click this, what will happen means this coding window will be open. Okay, this is the code window. Next, view design. I already told you the form window is the place where we design our application. If you want to see the design view means you just see use this button that is called as view designer button. When we click this means you just see the form window. So this is the part that solution explorer window, solution explorer window is used to switch over between what window? Coding window and designing window. It also shows the number of applications or number of forms in the application. Here by default it will I just displayed form1.vb. No, here I just indicate with the help of a mouse pointer form1. We open the name first form, form1. So if you add more forms means it can be displayed here. So this use of the solution explorer window is It is used to switch between design window and coding window. It also shows the number of forms that the application has. Parts of the VB environment. We just go through it, whatever we just learned. Objects. Here, it is very important to know that each and every tools in the toolbox, that is refers to as object in VB. In Zimper, we just called it as tools, no, but in VB, it is called as object. So, object is nothing but tools. Object are controlled like forms. Form is also a type of object. Okay. So, object means is nothing but tools. Okay. In Zimp, we just called as a tools. But in VB environment, we use the word object. Object or control, it refers to the tools. Object are controls like forms which have their own properties. I already told you properties windows used to change the property of each and every object. Now, so each and every control have their own properties. That properties can be used to change the color, size and etc. Okay. Next, form window. It is a place where you design your application. Toolbox means it contains various tools, but here we just refer to controls. Various controls that helps to design an application. Next one, properties window. Properties windows allows to change the properties of the forms and tools. Next one is a solution explorer window. The solution explorer window is otherwise called as project explorer window. It allows to switch between design window and coding window. It also shows the number of forms the application has. Here I just indicate the important keywords by means of a color called blue. Blue color, I just refer the important keywords. I highlight the important keywords by means of the color blue. Okay. Opening a new project. How will you open a new project? I already told you in each and every application, new, open, save are the options that are available in the menu called file. Okay. So likewise in the VB also, click on the file menu and select a new project option. Whenever you just select a new project option, a new project dialog box will be open. As soon as the dialog box will be open, you just select the option Windows Form Application and click the OK button. So I just show with the help of screenshot, go onto the file and then select the new option. After that, I just select the project, a new project dialog box will be open. I already showed the screenshot. Now I explain with the help of VB application. So I just minimize the PPT window, go to start, I just select the Visual Basic, so go to start all programs, Microsoft Visual Studio, I just select the option Microsoft Visual Studio 2007, this is a loading screen. Then after loading screen, what I told you, I just select the new project option. A new project dialog box will be opened. How will you identify? At the top, it displays the name new project. So what is the name of this dialog box? New project dialog box. In the new project dialog box, what you have to select? Windows Form Application. There are so many options are available in that. You just select Windows Form Application and click OK button. It is a step used to open a new project in VB. Okay, I just select the new project option. In a new project dialog box, I select the option Windows Form Application and click the OK button. Okay, this is a VB environment. We just explore in the VB environment. Here we just see the form window. I told you, this is the place where we design your application. It is called as the form window. And with the help of mouse pointer, I just refer it. This is a portion where we design your application. It is called as form window. At the top, it displays the name form. Okay. Next one. This is called as the toolbox. Whenever you just point out the mouse, the toolbox will be pop up. It contains various tools. It is important to know that in VB, we called it is each and every tool that can be called by means of a name called object or controls. Tools, we didn't use the term tools, we just use the word object or controls. Okay, next, move on to the properties window. If it is not available, go to the view option. and select the properties window. So this is a properties window. Okay, properties window, what I told that properties window means it is used to change the properties of each and every object. Okay, each and every event, we are going to write the coding with the help of various tools. You just create an application and each and every application has various controls. Programs has to be written for each event separately. Next, solution explorer window. I just go to the view and select the solution explorer option. The solution explorer window will be open. So solution explorer window, I already told you, know it is used to what? Switch between coding window and what window? Designing window. Okay, if you want to minimize the screen means you just minimize it as your this. By means of a mouse pointer you drag and drop it where you want. Okay, I want to place it here. Okay, this is a properties window and this is a solution explorer window. Okay, if it is not available in your VB environment means you just go to the view menu and select whatever windows you want. Solution explorer window, properties window, toolbox and all those are available in the view menu. Okay, so this is the environment we just learned. This portion is called as form window and this is called as a properties window and this portion is called a solution explorer window and this is called as the toolbox. In the solution explorer window, I had already told you, know view code and view design are the two options available. It is used to switch between coding window and designing window. I just click here, what will happen, you just listen it. View code means the code window will be open. Then view design means the designing window will be open. Okay, otherwise you just to use this option also at the top of the form window. You just to see the option form1.vb or form.vb. This is the coding window and this is the designing window. Just to click it, what will happen, the coding window will be open. If you click this means the designing window will be open here. Okay, if you want to open a new project means go to file, select new and project option. Okay, after this I just show you in the PPT. Now let us learn an important control. I already told you in Visual Basic tools are called as controls. There are so many tools available in the toolbox. Let us learn a new tool called label. Okay, you are going to learn a new tool that is called as a new control. The name is label. What is meant by label? Labels are the most frequently used control in VB. It is a most frequently used control in VB. Labels is mostly used to display in text or titles. So what, for what purpose we have to use the labels means to display any title or to display any text, you have to use the label control. It is like a sticker label where you use on your textbook or notebook. For what purpose you have to use it? To identify it belongs to whom. Okay, that book belongs to whom or which subject that book belongs, that book indicates it. In order to identify the purpose, we just use the label node for that. The same purpose, you have to use the label control in Visual Basic to display any text or to display the title, you have to use the label. Now, I just use the label control. How will you place a label control from the toolbox to the form window? Okay, you just go to the toolbox, select the label control and you have to draw it in the form window. Otherwise, you just double click the label control. It will be placed on the design window. That is the form window. Okay, so label 1. Now it is very important to know that whenever you click on the object or whenever you click on the control, that particular properties window will be open here. Here, let us listen there. I just place it on the form and make a click. What will happen? The form properties will be displayed in the properties window. Now I move the mouse pointer and place it on the label control and make a click. What will happen? In the properties window, label 1, that is the label control properties, will be enabled here. Okay. I already told you for what purpose you are going to use the label control. It is used to display text or titles. No, I just type a text. So what is the default property for label control? Mean text. Here in the properties window, you just listen here. Text, it is a property. It is a default property for label box. Okay, for control, the default property is text property. In the text property, whatever you just type, that can be displayed here. Okay, I just explained with the help of an example. I type the text as my bio data. Okay, so I want to display the title here. I already told you for what purpose label control can be used. It is used to display the text or titles. No, so I just display the title my bio data. For that, I just take the text option, text property of the label box, and type the data my bio data and click enter button. What will happen here? Look at the form window. My bio data is displayed. So like this, you just type the text in the label box. So what is the default property for the label control? Means text is the default property for the label control. Let us see how to change the font. This is a font size, color or style for this label control. I just type the data my bio data. I want to change the font size and style. What will I just to move to the font option in the properties window of label box. Let us listen carefully. I just select the label property window. Okay, label box or label control properties window. In that properties window, I just select the option font. Whenever you click on the font option, what will happen? A three dot button will be appear here. Okay, button with three dots appear here. I just indicate with the help of mouse pointer. I make a click, a dialog box will be open. What is the name of this dialog box? Font. Font is the name of this dialog box. It is very important. This picture is displayed in your textbook page number 47. It is a very important picture. Make a note on it. It is a font dialog box. In the dialog box, it is easy to change the font's type, style and size. Whatever you want, you just change it. Now I wish to change the font type. I just select the font type as monotype cursiva and font style as bold italic, and let us take the size as 20. Okay, after select whatever you want. Okay, it is not a compulsory one. If you want, means you have to change it with the help of what property? Font property. I change the type, style and size. After that, you just click the OK button. Now it will be changed like this. Okay, now go on to the next property. First you have to use the text property. Next one is font property. Now let us learn. If you want to change the font color, my bio data, it is displayed in black color. I wish to change the color, means what you have to do, select the option for color. Four color. Whenever you select the option four color, a down arrow will be appear here. Just click the down arrow. Three options that can be displayed. Custom web system. Look at this carefully. Custom web system. If you want to change the text color, means you just move on to the four color. In that, you just select custom option and whatever color you want, you just select it. Then the text color will be changed like this. Okay, now if you want to change the background color for this label, for this label control, if you wish to change the back color means, what you have to do? Select the property back color. It is similar to that of the four color property. Whenever you just click this, a down arrow will appear here. I just click the down arrow, then a pop-up menu will be opened. In that pop-up menu, three options are available: custom, web and system. For that, out of three, you just select the option custom and select the background color as you wish. I just select the color as this. Then the background of the label controller changed. Okay. Now, if you want to change the color of the form window, if you wish to change the form color, what you have to do? You just click the listen the properties window carefully. I select the label control now, so the label control properties will be displayed here. Whenever you move the mouse pointer and paste it on the form window and make a click means, then as well as the form window properties, that form is also in control. Okay, so that property will be enabled here. Go to the back color, select back color and click the down arrow. Out of the three option, you just click the custom option and you just select the color whatever you want. I click the color like this. What will happen? Background of the form color will be changed. Okay. After designing your application, what you have to do? You want to, you wish to run the program now. For this, you just select the run button. It is called as a run button. I just indicate with the help of mouse pointer, that can be highlighted here. If you click the run button, then the application will be run. Okay, otherwise you just use the function key. What is that function key? Means F5, F1 to F12 function keys are available in your keyboard. If you press F5 button means, then your VB application will be run. I just click the run button here. So this is my application. Okay. So in order to run the VB program, you have to press F5 key or click the run button. That run button is available in the toolbar. Okay. Now I just go through it with the help of a PowerPoint. Label control. Let us see the label control. Labels are one of the most frequently used control in Visual Basic. Label is used to display text or titles. Then default property for the label is text property. In the text property only, whatever you wish to display, you just type it in the text portion. Okay. The properties window has all the properties for the control that are used in the form. I just explained with the help of screenshot. The label control, just select the label control. What will happen? Whenever I click the label control, the properties window automatically changed. Okay, label one properties will be displayed here. In that, I just select the text option to display the text. I just type the text as my first VB project. Now I wish to change the font means, click on three buttons, that is three dotted button that is available to the font property. Whenever you just click it means, font dialog box will be open. In the three options are available. What are they means? Font, font style and font size. If you want to make a change means, you just change it and click OK button. So the font has changed. I just indicate with the help of screenshot, font, then the three dotted button is here. Whenever I click this, the font dialog box will be appear like this. In that, I just select the font type, strain and size. After that, I just click the OK button. Okay, this is a way used to change the font property of a label control. Let us move the back color. How to change the back color property of a label control? Click on the down arrow that is available near the back color property. Whenever you just select the desired color, then the label background color can be changed. So I just show it. Down, whenever you select the down arrow, a pop-up menu will be appear. In that, custom, web, system, three options are available. You just select the custom option. What will happen? different colors are displayed there, and you select a wish to color. Next, how to change the fork color. Fork color means, it is important to know that if you want to change the text color, means you have to use the fork color property. If you want to change the background color, means you just use the back color property. So click on the down arrow near the fork color property and click the custom tab and select the desired color as your wish. Step to change the background color of the form. How to change the background color of the form? The same steps to be followed. Click on the form and take the properties window of a form and change the back color property of the form. Next, steps to run the VB program. There are two ways to run the VB program. First, you have to select the run button that is available in the toolbar, or you just click the F5 key that is available in your keyboard. To see the result, you must execute the project. To do so, press F5 key or click on the run button. This is a run button icon that is available in the toolbar to see the results. I just indicate the help of screenshot. Let us see the points to remember. What is VB? It is a simple programming language. It is an event-driven programming language. That event can be happened by means of three ways. Click on a button, type a text, or select an item from a list. Here the tools are called as objects or controls. Each and every tool have their own properties. Form window is the place where you design your application. Toolbox means it contains various tools that helps you to design an application. Properties windows allows to change the properties of each and every control. Solution Explorer window is otherwise called as Project Explorer window. It is used to switch between design window and coding window. Plus, it also shows the number of forms the application project has. Then an important control, label. It is the most frequently used control. It is used to display text or titles. The default property for label control is text to property. To run the VB application, you have to use either F5 key or click a run button that is available in the toolbar. This is the end of this chapter. Thank you, students. Thank you.